Hey guys, Sajik here, welcome to Pixel Stories. In this week's video, we're going to talk about how you can do a quick photo shoot in your home with your mobile phone. I'm going to be using things that you can find it at home. I'm going to be using an LED light, which I bought a video LED light, but you can replace it with any table lamp or an LED light that you can find it in your home. So, this video is going to be in three sections. One, setup, second, shoot, and third, editing. When I go through setup, I'll show you how I set up the light and why I'm setting up that way and how many lights that I'm using, and also when I shoot, I'll tell you what's the exposure that I'm setting, what are all the setups I take it as a priority, and when I focus, when I take a shot, what are all the things I look in the subject that need to be prominent, and when I edit the shoot, edit the image, I will tell you when I edit it, what I am focusing on and why I am using the specific settings to highlight such things. Okay, so that's gonna be our three sections of this video. Cool. Let's just jump right in. So yeah, this is a setup, right? And this is a main light. And this main light is gonna light one side of the subject, right? So in the shoot, I am using this as a subject. And you can also see background as a black, right? And the subject also is pitch black, not finished, right? So that means that if I just keep the product and then just take a shot, what's gonna happen is the subject and the background is gonna merge because both are black, right? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this subject and I am light from this side, one side. So what happens is there is this one highlight forms which separates the product from the background. So that's what the purpose of this main light. You light to one side so that, okay, and I'm going to use a silver sheet here. I don't know what this sheet is called, I just have it for purposes. You can buy it in station, or if you have the packing foil paper foil sheet, you can use that as well, which will reflect the same light, right? So you can use anything that's reflective, right? Just keep it white or silver color. Recently, if you're using any other colors, when the light gets reflected, that is the color as well. So if you kept a pink sheet or something, when the light gets reflected, the pink color also gets put on the product, which you don't want, right? The color thing you don't want. So that's why I'm keeping the silver foil here, silver sheet here, and reflecting it, right? So just by using this one powerful light, what I'm doing, I'm lighting both sides of the subject. Now that you have this white light that separates the product from the background, second important thing comes the logo, right? So whenever you do photo shoots, product photo shoots especially, there has to be separate focus to be given for the logo, right? Because it has to pop up. That's the main idea of you doing the product. People have to look at the product name, the logo, right? So what I'm doing, I'm going light from the bottom, lighting up this. Okay, I'm not using this a full light. Okay. So what I have done is I have taken a candle LED light and I have did this cut. Okay, so you can see it here. So this is a rectangle and with a small stripe over in the front. So, and I tape it over the light and then I light it. What happens is only a small amount of light falls into this logo. Okay. And again, here guys, when you keep the light on the bottom, just make sure it lights only this area. And the second thing is, it doesn't become too reflective. The reason behind it, at certain angle, the glossy surface will reflect the light at a very high intensity. Like for example, if I am holding this, you can see like at one point, like this point and this point, you can see how the highlight is differs, right? In at this angle, let's say if I am using this angle, you can read the logo is prominent, but it is not too reflective. But at this point, when it comes to this, it just becomes a very highlight, right? Very bright white highlight, which you don't want it, right? So you figured out at what angle that you are still able to read the whole logo, but at the same time it doesn't become distracted. So you just move your light in a way and look at it through the mobile and see at what point the light fits. And you set up the second light. And the thing is, that's pretty much it. That's a pretty much only light that you are using. And I'll just give an idea into the backgrounds and the bottoms that I can. The flow panel I'm using is a pattern chart which has a background pattern so that it doesn't become just black. And the background I'm using is my black sheet. Okay, so that when I keep the subject here and I'm lighting here, so the front part of it will have certain patterns, it doesn't become very black. And as it goes through it, it just fades into complete black. So that's the idea. So that's why I'm using these two. And that's pretty much it. You can just go ahead and shoot it. And when I'm shooting this image, what I'm looking for is three things. One, I am using low ISO because the whole light is in my control. I am setting up how much I light and how much intensity of light I need and everything. So what I'm doing is I'm keeping ISO as 200 and I'm going to set the focus part. So when I adjust the focus, I'm going to be focusing on this look. Even though the product is my subject, I'm not going to focus on the idea is not to get the whole thing. When somebody looks at the screen, this should get the eyes, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to focus specifically here and I'm going to manually adjust the focus here. And third thing is adjust the shutter speed. And when I adjust the shutter speed, I look for three things. One, this should be still clear, right? That means when I adjust the shutter speed, I look whether at what point this logo is clear and very bright, right? And second thing is this edge line shouldn't fade into darkness. It shouldn't just become dark and completely defeat the purpose. So I'll make sure I can see the logo, I can see the edge, right? And third thing I look for is the background is dark, but at the same time it doesn't become too dark that subject and the background merge together, which I don't want it either. So that's the three things I look for, and I adjusted the shutter speed. In this case it came to 1/80. At 1/80 I can see the edges, I can also see the background and the foreground subject as well. So I can see everything and I pick the shot. Okay. Now let's just move into edit. Again, when I edit it also, I'm going to focus on the exact same thing that we focused on initially. Because that's the whole idea from the beginning, right? I want the logo to be prominent, I want highlights to be prominent, right? That's the whole thing I look for. In that case, is what I'm going to look for. When I edit, that's what I'm going to look for is I'm going to select it and I'm going to adjust the brightness and contrast. The brightness is going to affect only the brightest part where there is a direct light falling on. Only those parts get bright and subtle little. And when I adjust the contrast, what happens is if there is a light part and if there is a dark part, it increases the brightness to the brightest part and increase the dark to the shadow part. So that it's the bright spot stands out well, right? So that's the whole idea behind our logo popping up a little bit. And I'm gonna adjust that. I'm gonna adjust since it is a golden color and everything, there is no saturation, it's much needed. I'm gonna adjust the ambience a little bit. Ambience light is pretty much light surrounding the subject, right? So it will bring more detail from the shadows if it's required. So these adjustments are to your taste. Okay, so in this product, I look for this as my main focus point. So I only focused on that point and I adjusted the other things so that this is not it going at the same time, there is no other distraction. That's the whole point of adjusting this. And once I'm finished with it, I'm going to be selecting curves. Curves is a really powerful, okay? And if you're a photographer, you use it very often. Okay? And so imagine this L curve, right? In this L curve, this is the highlight, the top point is the highlight and the bottom point is the status. Okay, so if you push the highlights up, wherever there is a bright, it will become brighter. But if you push the shadow part up, wherever there is a shadow, it will become brighter. So if you want to bring more detail from it, you push the shadow part up. If you want to make the shadows much darker, you push the shadow part down. Okay, so that's X. S curve is typical S curve, which is pushing the brightness up and reducing the darkness up. That brings the contrast in the frame, which creates the drama in the image. Okay, so here also I'm going to do pretty much the same. Push the brightness up, reduce the darkness. And once I'm done with it, I'm going to be using selective tool, because in this one, there are a few things I told you important that I'm looking for. What I'm going to do next step is to specifically focus on this individual thing and brighten those things up. Okay, so I'm going to select the edges of the white edges of the bottle, and then I'm specifically just increase the brightness and increase the contrast a bit so that the white line stands up. And second thing is the logo, and I'm going to select the each logo part like Park Avenue and Euphoria and then Perfume. That's logo text. I'm going to be selecting those specific colors and increase the brightness. So that's where the selective tool comes in. The selective tool, you can select specific color, and then you can use two fingers to zoom in and zoom out of how much this should impact, and you can adjust the brightness of it, contrast, saturation, and structure. Structure here is kind of a clarity tool, okay, which brings up more punch in the frame. Okay, so I'm going to be selecting only those areas, only the highlights of it and the logos of it. Only those two elements I'm going to give specific attention to that. Once I'm done with it, I'm going to be using the healing tool to remove any distractions. So when I say distractions, it could be dust. Like even though I clean this bottle like two or three times, and because it's a matte finish with the soft surface, even if I hold like this, my fingerprints are all over the bottle. So similar to that, there will be dust when we shoot it. Try to avoid as much as possible, but you can't avoid 100%. So I'm just gonna clean up any spots that I messed up, and that's pretty much it. So if you look at it, within like few minutes, we can set up the shot, take the shot, and edit it as well, and everything can be done on your mobile, right? And once you know what you really want, if you know how to play with lights, any products can be. So yes, in the initial time you'll have to try it out, keep the lights in different angles, keep the camera in different angles, and see how it works. And when you are happy with it, go with it. Okay, so yes, that's pretty much it. With your mobile phone, the lights that you can find it in your room, and some charts, you can actually get the light that you wanted. You can get the frame that you want. The outcome of the shoot, you can post it on social media or on the website. It's completely fine. For digital mediums, it will be really good. In fact, like I posted the outcome of this shoot in Instagram a couple of days back. You can check out this post here, and I also have the guidelines there as well. So later point of time, if you want to go back and then refer to the setup, you can refer to that post in the video. And if you're not following me on Instagram, follow me on Instagram. I share photographic tips, how to shoot, how to do video, all those things are on my channel, on my Instagram. And also you can check the link on the bio, on Instagram bio, where I have given up photography guides in a PDF format, which you can download and refer at any point of time. So if you're a photographer, or if you're using smartphone to photograph your travel, your life, or anything you like, follow on Instagram and also subscribe to the channel and click on the bell button. Thank you.